Welcome into the Cowboys Report. On today's show, we're going to break down some safety targets for the Cowboys in NFL free agency. Before we dive into that, though, I want to make sure everybody is subscribed because I know you all aren't. We got about 50% of you who watch the show yet are not subscribed. And safety targets in free agency, that's not the only targets video we'll do this offseason. Plenty of draft ones and other positions as well for NFL free agency. So if you don't want to miss out, hit that big red button and subscribe. Let's dive in here to some potential discussion in the end. The Cowboys, in reality, have a massive and major need for an impact-free safety. Now, I'm not yet sure just how much money the team is in reality willing to allocate to the spot. Historically, hasn't been a position they really value. But Dan Quinn comes in. If you're going to try and run more cover one and more cover three, you need a rangy single high free safety. And the good news is, I think it's a pretty strong free agency crop for that position. I like Donovan Wilson a lot. I think he is a keeper and someone who should start for this organization next season. But that's just one of your spots. And although I think you could give Wilson some reps in a deeper safety role, I don't think you want him back there consistently as your deep coverage guy. Now, you'll mix it up. You're not going to just be as simple and basic as I'm making it sound, but you still want someone who can play that deep safety role. I don't want that to be Xavier Woods. If you roll into next year with Xavier Woods as your starting free safety, I'm going to be pretty disappointed again. You also probably want some depth as well, but I think there's enough options in free agency to go out and sign somebody, regardless of how expensive it might end up being, because you can afford it. That's how the salary cap works. You can make money to impact that spot and impact your secondary in a way this team desperately needs. First up is my number one free agent safety. That is Justin Simmons. Now, there's no guarantee he's going to be available. And there's also some Dak Prescott implications here. Namely, if you pay Dak, you free up extra money for yourself on this year's salary cap to afford Justin Simmons. And you can structure both deals in a way to have it be less impactful this year and more later, like how most teams do, because the salary cap goes up. Once the COVID impact is gone, which it will be down the road, and the TV money comes in, it's going to be way up there in terms of the salary cap. The issue potentially here is that Justin Simmons and Dak Prescott share the same agent. What do we know about Todd France? Number one, he ain't going to take a discount. Number two, if you don't pay Dak, you're not getting Justin Simmons. There's no way Todd France will be like, yeah, let's go to Dallas where they already had a bunch of issues. So if Denver doesn't pay him, which they should, he is a top five safety, the numbers bear that out, then I have interest for sure, but only comes if you end up paying Dak Prescott. All right, Marcus May, another guy I would love to get on this organization. I think he'd be a great single high free safety, coming off his best year for the Jets. But you know what's funny about New York? They're probably going to run a similar style defense since it's they hired Robert Saleh to be their head coach. He'll have plenty of influence there. It's a similar style scheme, and the Jets have plenty of cap space. They might be a bad football team right now, but Marcus May is one of like their few really good defensive players. Really good players overall. So if you're the Jets, I think you just pay Marcus May. So in the event that Simmons and or May get to the open market, yes, I have interest. We'll see if the Cowboys are willing to spend, but those would be probably your dream targets for the Dallas Cowboys. So let me know in the comments what safety you want the Dallas Cowboys to sign. It doesn't have to be the biggest name, could be a smaller name. This question is going to be the pinned comment on today's video. So if you get the ad break here on YouTube, scroll on down and get your votes in. Let's go to someone who I like a lot and I think could actually hit the open market. Marcus Williams of the New Orleans Saints. The Saints are kind of up against the cap. They've been pushing money down the road to try and win with Drew Brees, which was smart. At some point, it kind of comes due, and Marcus Williams might be a little bit too expensive for them to retain. Former second-round pick. I don't think he's as good as Simmons or May, but he's a significant upgrade over Xavier Woods, and I don't think he's going to break the bank in the same way those first two guys end up would. Well, it wasn't English at all. End up would. What am I talking about? End up could doing, or something along those lines. All right, Anthony Harris here, next up. His interception totals dropped pretty significantly from 2019 to 2020. I don't know if he is a perfect one-to-one fit as a single high free safety. He can do it. I don't think he's nearly as good as some of the other guys we just mentioned. He's a good football player. I think he wants to get paid significantly. So I think he ends up hitting the open market. I monitor that one. But maybe you want to save money at safety, invest it in a defensive tackle. If that's the case, you probably pass on Anthony Harris. And I think Malik Hooker, the Colts safety, makes a lot of sense if you're going to try and save some money and not wildly commit to one individual safety. Malik Hooker is talented. He is a perfect fit as a single high safety. He's not an elite run stopper, but in 36 games, injury's a big factor here. 11 pass breakups, 7 interceptions. If you're not going to throw money at a Marcus Williams or a Marcus May or a Justin Simmons, I like Malik Hooker a lot. Remember, those of you who have been subscribed for a while, I was trying to get Malik Hooker on this team last offseason. If I can do it now at what I think would be a pretty discounted rate, I'm all for it. And if you sign Malik Hooker, you can still draft somebody if you like that, if you like a prospect in day two or whenever in the NFL draft. So is this the year that the Cowboys finally invest at safety? I don't know about you guys. I am ready to get myself hurt again. I believe this is the year the Cowboys will do it. So I'm going to type in my Y for yes, but if you disagree, type in your N for no. All right, John Johnson, another expensive safety, had a fantastic year for the LA Rams. Very curious what ends up happening with him. Brandon Staley, his defensive coordinator, is now with the Chargers, but they got Derwin James and a guy we'll get to here in a little bit, and Nasir Adderley, so that might not make the most sense for the Chargers. He's going to be expensive. I don't know if he's a true perfect fit as a single high guy. I think he's better as more of a split safety or even a box safety at times. He's expensive. I think there's a better free safety out there. But if you were in the market for a strong safety as well, maybe you don't believe in Donovan Wilson, Johnson absolutely makes some sense at that point. Now let me know what free agent position target video you guys want next. Is it defensive tackle? Is it linebacker, cornerback? Let me know in the comments section. We're going to get to all of these as the season goes along, but I'll pay attention and try and prioritize one that you guys want next. Next up is Rayshon Jenkins, the safety from the Chargers, who is a free agent. Derwin James coming back. Nasir Adderley, a young player. The last year, Jenkins played a lot more strong safety because of Derwin James' injury. The year before that, he played a lot more free safety. I like the flexibility of having someone who can do both. I don't think he'd be an ideal fit as a full-time free safety necessarily, but if he's not that expensive, rolling into next year with Rayshon Jenkins and with Donovan Wilson is better, as far as I'm concerned, than with Wilson and Xavier Woods starting. Because of some potentially former, Falcons players, Demonte Casey is next up here. Only played 4 games because of injury this year. 5'11", 190 is not prototypical free safety size, but his best year came as a free safety under Dan Quinn. Now, he's played some nickel, played some strong. If you want to bring him in as a potentially cheaper free safety, kind of in that Malik Hooker mold, with someone who has familiarity with that defense, I'm actually on board with that. I don't know if you're going to get his 2018 campaign all over again, but from a cost perspective, I think it does make some sense in terms of value. The other Falcons safety, Keanu Neal, arguably a better pure player than Demonte Casey. The issue is, he's a box safety. I want to keep Donovan Wilson in that role. Now, if Keanu Neal is super cheap, the answer is always yes, right? And could play kind of a dime linebacker safety hybrid role, I'm intrigued by that. But I'm trying to find a free safety, and I don't think Keanu Neal is quite that fit for the Dallas Cowboys. Chatsports.com/bet. You type in that URL right now in your browser or your phone or wherever. It'll take you right into the BetUS site. The promo code to go along with it is Cowboys125. You do those two things, you will get a 125% deposit bonus. That's simple. Put down $100. Boom, extra 125 for free. That's a much better return on investment than trying to go with the Dogecoin, which I invested in and gained some money, but nowhere near as much as you will on BetUS. And I'm giving you guys some free picks here as well. I got the Chiefs over Tampa in the Super Bowl, and life's too short to ever bet the under. Give me the over in that game. Under a half Biden mention, so I'm saying there's going to be zero Biden mentions. They're not going to talk about that during this year's broadcast. Commercials don't count. It's only during the game. And Patriots, they're going to mention that at least two times. I'll take the plus 120 action on that one. You can take my bets or fade them like I do producer Sam's bets. Chatsports.com/bet. Use that promo code Cowboys125. All right, some more safeties here. Tashawn Gibson coming off a pretty good year for the Chicago Bears. He's played strong safety. He's played free safety. Had you kept Mike Nolan, I actually think Gibson might have been a slightly better fit in that particular role. But as an older player, he's not going to be as expensive. So I'm at least going to explore that particular market if I miss out on some of my other better options. All right, Carl Joseph, a name we've mentioned many a time on the Dallas Cowboys Report. I am convinced he needs to be a box safety. He's continued to play kind of both strong safety and free safety. If I didn't have Donovan Wilson, I would be all aboard the sign Carl Joseph train. But I do. I don't want him as my single high free safety. I don't think that's maximizing his talents. So if he's cheap and I bring him in as my third safety, okay, now we're talking. But I can't sign him and go, okay, I'm done at the free safety spot. Let me know what you guys think the Cowboys' biggest free agency need is. Not just draft need or overall need, but free agency focus. Is it safety? Is it corner? Is it defensive tackle? Let me know what you guys think. One player here to wrap up quickly, Jalen Mills, who has done a little bit of everything. He played outside corner, played slot corner, played free safety, played strong safety for the Philadelphia Eagles. They were a bad secondary. Mills was solid. I don't love this idea, but if you're looking for someone to fill a spot somewhere in the secondary, Jalen Mills does make some sense there. But again, I think you can find a more dynamic, a more rangy free safety, be it Malik Hooker, DeMonte Casey on the cheap, or an expensive guy, Marcus Williams, Marcus May, or Justin Simmons. But just keep an eye out for Jalen Mills if Stephen Jones wants to go bargain shopping once again in NFL free agency.